Hello everyone, welcome to Design Minds channel. In this video I am going to explain how to create a different header and footer. Okay, so this is the sample document that I am using to show you the header and footer. Before I start, let me show you the preview of this document, which has no header and footer. Also you will see the strategy and strategy 1, strategy 2, strategy 3, 4, it started. Okay, so I'm going to use the respective header and footer for the respective strategy 1 and the respective strategy 2, 3 and 4 and so on. Okay, so let me close the preview. And before you start on to the header and footer, you need to make sure to add two things. Okay, here I am placing the cursor, strategy 1 title. Okay, now I need to see where the page break and section break and paragraph mark is added. To see this information, all you have to do is go to the home tab and you will see the paragraph icon. Just click on it. You will see the paragraph mark and the page break and the section break, whatever the information has been used in this document. Okay, to see the paragraph mark, you can use the shortcut key also by pressing Ctrl+Shift+8 to show the paragraph mark and page break and section break. To view again, you can press same Ctrl+Shift+8. It will show, it will hide if you press the Ctrl+Shift+8. Okay. Now I am viewing the paragraph marks. Okay. Before you add the header and footer, if you want the different header and footer for the strategy 1, 2, 3 and 4, all you have to do is just go to the previous page of the strategy 1. Okay, I'm going to delete the blank page. Okay, I'm going to delete this page also. Okay, now I'm placing the cursor here. Okay, go to the page layout, click on the break. Click on the section break, next page. Okay, if you see, there is a section break has been added in the previous page and the strategy 1 has been started in the new page. Let me explain why I have added the section break here. Okay, because if I added the strategy 1 header, it will automatically reflect the same header in the previous page also. To avoid that, I just added the section break, which enable the link to previous section button here to cut off the same header reflecting into the previous page. Okay, otherwise it will not show. If the normal page break is been added here, it will not show the link to previous page. Okay, only when we add the section break, it will show you the link to previous page option to disconnect the same header reflecting into the previous page. Okay, now before I add the new header, I have to unlink the link to previous page. Just click on it under the design tab, just click on it by switching off and add your new strategy title 1, and I'm going to type the header just to understand easily, make it right align. Same way, go to the footer and unlink with the previous page. I'm going to copy the same one, pasting into the footer. I'm going to the left align and change it to the footer and close the header and footer. Now I'm going to see the preview. You will see the previous, all this previous page doesn't have a header and footer because we added a section break and unlinked the header to not reflect into the previous page. Now let me show you strategy 1 header, strategy 1 footer. Everything is showing fine, but if you see, it is reflecting into the strategy 2 and 3 and 4 throughout the pages. Okay, to avoid this, what you have to do is, to start the different header and footer for the strategy 2, all you have to do is go to the strategy 2 page, which is page 14. I'm closing the preview. Okay, directly going into the page 14. There, strategy 2. So before I place the different header for the strategy 2, I'll have to add the section break instead of page break. Okay. You see, without adding the section break, it will not allow you to the link you to the previous section. Okay, it will collapse. If you add the new header and footer for the strategy 2, it will reflect and overwrite the strategy 1 sections also. So for that reason only, I am going to remove the page break before the strategy 2 started. Okay, place the cursor here, go to the page layout, click on the breaks under the section break, click on the next page break. Okay, now you will see the section break has been added to the page before the strategy 2. Now you can remove the blank page, remove it. Okay, now it's time to add a new header and footer for the strategy 2 section. Let me double click. Okay, you'll see the link to previous section has been enabled. All you have to do is switch off. Okay, then replace with the new header for the strategy 2. Same way, you have to go to the footer and disconnect the link. Just you have to do the first page of the strategy 2. I mean the respective strategy. You don't have to do all the pages for the strategy 2. Okay, now I am clicking on the close header and footer. Now I am previewing the document. As you can see, strategy 1 started with strategy 1 header and footer. Then strategy 2 started header and footer. You see, strategy 2 is keep on continuing until the strategy 3 also. To cut off the strategy 2 before the strategy 3, just close it and follow the same steps by scrolling down. You see the strategy 3 started. Now all you have to do is add a section break here, remove the page break. Don't worry if the strategy 3 started next to the previous end of the strategy 2. Just enter mark, place the cursor, go to the page layout, click on the break, under the section break, click on the next page, section break. If you scroll down, scroll up, you'll see the section break has been added. Scroll down, remove the paragraph mark, then double click for the strategy 3 section. Make sure you unlink to not reflect the strategy 3 header into the previous strategy 2. I'm replacing strategy 3. Same way, we have to go to the footer, unlink it, select strategy 3 and close. Now let's see the preview. Now you'll see the strategy 1 stopped here, and strategy 2, strategy 3 started here. Let me show you the simple preview, two page preview. Strategy 1, then strategy 2, then strategy 3, and strategy 3, here also strategy 3. Same way, you have to go to the strategy 4 page and add a section break here. If you see the page break, remove it, don't forget. After that only you have to add the section break, then double click the strategy 4 header and unlink the previous section header button, then add your new header for the strategy 4. That's it. Same way, you have to add the footer also for the strategy 4. So this way you can add a different header and footer for the respective number of pages in the document. So that is all. Let me know if any clarification in this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share the video. Any clarification, please feel free to reach me out through the comment or the email. Thank you so much for watching the video.